with a popper, niggas wanna steal me. I can't bust down proper, make these niggas hate me. Crazy how I love the same with that try to kill me. Still stood on solid principles when these niggas ain't feel me. Need somebody lined up, I get the job done. You ain't know I strip niggas and I rob plus. Different flavors and it's what happened to pop.
What's good, y'all? It's your main man, Daquan, and I'm back with another video for y'all. And in this video, we're going to be showing the best bat setups for every playstyle for guards in 2K22. There's three playstyles we're going to be showing. These three on the screen. We're going to start with the first one on the left and work all the way to the right, which is the slashing primary. We're going to start with the two guards who can't really get Hall of Fame finishing badges. You feel me? But first off, we got Limitless Takeoff to start the video, and this is going to be a trend you're going to be seeing throughout the video. And just pause the screen for however many badges you have, you're going to see it on the left. And if this is your playstyle, the main guard or ISO player or just the main person with the ball in the hand, and then the second category you seen in the beginning, that's going to be the secondary player, secondary ball handler, or a lockdown. And then the third is if you have slashing primary, which you're able to get 30 finishing badges or up to. We're gonna be showing on the bottom left of the screen, you see the max badge count and level. That's what we're gonna be going to for the main guard, ISO, whatever you want to call it, just because they're more likely you're not gonna be able to get that much. But now we're on to the secondary ball handler slash lockdown, and as you can see, we're going up to 20 this time. And like we did in the beginning, we're starting off with that Limitless Takeoff. You don't have any other badges, you don't have enough badges to help you finish layups with only like one or two badges, so it only makes sense to put them on Limitless to start off and then work our way up to that level. Now with this category, you're gonna want to focus more on finishing your dunks and layups just as much as possible, just because you're most likely not gonna have as many touches with the ball compared to the main guard. Whereas you seen we are focusing more on slithery, Limitless Takeoff, just not getting touched. Whereas this one, we need to focus more on the bigger picture. Now, do what I'm doing right here. If you have this money, Limitless Takeoff, that fast twitch is very underrated. I'm gonna be doing a video, or I'm gonna try to do videos on every single badge in the game. Just how good is whatever badge. Shooting is gonna be a little bit hard, but we still gonna try to get it done. And I know y'all see the badges right here: Limitless, Fearless, Slithery, and then Posterizer is the lowest of them all. That's for a reason. If you're the secondary ball handler or the lockdown, you're most likely not gonna be able to just go for contact dunks left and right. I know it doesn't only help with contacts, it helps with finishing around the rim, but Slithery, I'd say, is definitely more helpful in the aspect of not getting contact dunks but still finishing around the rim, as well as Fearless finisher mixed in with that, you feel me, as well as fast twitch, acrobat. And this is going to sum it up for the 20 badge count. And now we're on to the primary slashing, or slashing primary, however you want to say it. We're going to go up to 30, but again, start off with that Limitless Takeoff. Two badges is not enough to help you finish around the rim, at least as not as much as not getting touched. But then we're gonna advance just like we're doing before: Fearless finisher, Slithery finisher, Posterizer. And now when it comes to Posterizer in this category, we're in a whole different ballpark. We can actually start going for contacts now, just because we are able to get that rating as well as get the badges on Hall of Fame. But again, just go ahead and copy what I'm doing if you do have the badge count, if you want to. Shit, you don't even have to do what I'm doing. If you're confident in what you got, go ahead and use what you got. But this is just, in my opinion, what would be the best for this badge count that I'm showing. I thought well and hard for my choices. So yeah, just know y'all can trust me. But Fearless finisher, 15 at that Lob City. And look, you're good to go. 15 badges, we're looking gravy already. Look, Slithery at that Hall of Fame. Limitless Takeoff. You see how we're not maxing one thing out then maxing another thing out? We're spreading it around for the amount of badges we have. Like we start off with Limitless Takeoff, we're not gonna automatically put Fearless finisher up and then lack in other categories. We're obviously gonna try to build our badge count to help us in every aspect. But again, just go ahead and copy what I'm doing. Unstrippable. That's a good batch to have on at least bronze. It's gonna help you with those weird ass dudes running that ball stripper badge. I actually tested it out a little bit on next gen. It was looking kind of ass. I haven't tested it out on current gen, but we'll see. But we're getting to the end right here. Giant Slayer, Grace Under Pressure. That Giant Slayer was kind of ass last year, but if you do have the extra badges, go ahead and put that on just to get bailed out in certain situations. And then last but not least, Lob City, Grace Under Pressure, and y'all see it. But if you enjoyed the video, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe.